have our opening song, In the Garden. And so we begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And may the God of hope give you fullness of peace, and may the Lord of life be with you always. My brothers and sisters, we believe that all the ties of friendship and affection which has won throughout our lives does not unravel with death. Confident that God always remembers the good that we have done and forgives our sins. Let us pray, asking God to gather our daughter, his daughter to himself. Lord our God, the death of our sister recalls our human condition and the brevity of our lives on earth. But for those who believe in your love, death is not the end, nor does it destroy the bonds that you forge in our lives. We share the faith of your son's disciples and the hope of the children of God. Bring the light of Christ's resurrection to this time of testing and pain as we pray for Lynette and for those who love her, through Christ our Lord. And reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. We know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made but eternal in heaven. And so we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith and not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we'd rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away, for we all must appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each one may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, either good or evil. The Gospel of the Lord. And our response is, the Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my help. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Before whom shall I shrink? The Lord is my light and my salvation. There is one thing I ask of the Lord, for this I long, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to savor the sweetness of the Lord, to behold his temple. The Lord is my light and my salvation. O Lord, hear my voice when I call. Have mercy and answer. It is your face, O Lord, that I seek. Hide not your face. The Lord is my light and my salvation. I am sure I shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living. Hope in him, hold firm, take heart, hope in the Lord. The Lord is my light and my salvation. And a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus told his disciples, gird your loins and light your lamps, and be like servants who await their master's return from a wedding, ready to open immediately when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds vigilant on his arrival. Amen, I say to you, he will gird himself, have them recline at table, and proceed to wait on them. And should he come in the second or the third watch and find them prepared this way, blessed are those servants. Be sure of this, if the master of the house had known the hour when the thief was coming, he would not have let his house be broken into. You also must be prepared, for an hour that you do not expect, the Son of Man will come. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You know, one of the troubles with my job, but one of the things that's also a blessing about it, is lots of times I don't meet people when they're young and healthy. That, I've been here in town long enough now that I'm starting to, but lots of times I don't meet people until they're older. And that's fine, because you can tell by how, when they are older, what they were like when they were younger. If you are old and bitter and cranky, you were young, bitter, and cranky. And so it's easy to tell. And so while I did not know her young, it is very easy to know that she was not young, bitter, and crazy, but a person who knew how to love, a person who knew how to praise God, and a person of faith. Sometimes you don't know people until they're older, but you know exactly what they were young because of the way they are old. And so we have gathered to celebrate a life that is well lived. Yes, there is a whole list of things that she did in her life. Jobs she had, people she touched, children she raised. But in the end, we are gathered here to celebrate a woman of faith and a woman who lived well. That is what we have come to celebrate. It is really sad when people gather and they have no good life to celebrate, but are instead happy. It is always nice when people gather in sadness to celebrate, because that means that she was loved and cherished. And that is a good thing. Your sadness is a celebration of her life. And let us turn to Christ Jesus with confidence and faith in the power of his cross and resurrection. And if you'd respond, Lord, have mercy. Risen Lord, pattern of our life forever. Lord, have mercy. Promise and image of what we shall be. Lord, have mercy. Son of God, who came to destroy death itself. Lord, have mercy. Word of God, who delivered us from the fear of death. Lord, have mercy. Crucified Lord, forsaken in death and raised in glory. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, bless those who mourn and who are in pain, and bless her friends and family who have gathered around her today. Lord, have mercy. And together we pray in the words our Lord has given us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, you willingly gave yourself up to death so that all might be saved and pass from death to life. We humbly ask you to comfort your servants in their grief. You alone are the Holy One, you are mercy itself. By dying, you unlock the gates of life for those who believe. Forgive her her sins and grant her a place of happiness, light, and peace in the kingdom of your glory forever and ever. Amen. And blessed are those who have died in Christ. Let them rest in their labors, for their good deeds go with them. And eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let your perpetual light shine upon her. And may she rest in peace. And may her soul and the souls of all of the faithfully departed through the mercies of God rest in peace. Amen. And after our concluding prayer, everyone is invited upstairs for further fellowship. And may the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge of the love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And may Almighty God bless you all in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Everybody sing along if you know the words.
Thank you. concludes our service today. There is lunch and fellowship upstairs, and there's plenty of food. So I encourage everybody to go upstairs and enjoy that and share memories of Lynette. If anybody needs assistance getting upstairs, just reach out to me or one of my staff members. If you're ready.
Yeah, the elevator back through there. I'll come and get you when you're ready.
No problem. Thank you.